It's one of the most hostile environments. So how prepared are you after seeing what Ottawa did and having a few games on the road already this year?
Yeah, I'm prepared. I think that we've done a good job all week too with working some different snap counts. So I feel prepared. I think the team does as well.
What's your history in loud games like this? Where have you played that would rival something like this?
I played at, I think the loudest stadium I ever played at was probably Nebraska my junior year. That place got pretty loud. I think that was like 95,000. And then Texas was pretty loud. That was over 100,000. I think 103,000. And also the loudest, other than those two, was actually Boise State, which is under 40. But for some reason, that place gets rocking. So those are probably the three loudest I've been to.
Is the crowd noise here adequate, do you think, to get done what you need to prep-wise?
Yeah, definitely. And we have those big speakers that simulate game noise as well. And we've been working, like I said, been working certain snap counts that I think should benefit us come game time.
Did the noise contribute to some of the problems in Ottawa?
Yeah, definitely. There were a couple that we just weren't on the right page, and I took a little too much time. So, I can't do that.
It was an emotional finish to the game. There's a lot of unnecessary roughness penalties and things like that going on. What do you expect in the back-to-back?
Oh, I mean, I expect things to be amped up even more than they were the first time. But that's where, I mean, being a vet, you got to keep a cool head and know that, I mean, the team is above all else. Any little personal issues you got and all that, the win in the team is way more important. So you can't get involved in that.
Did you sense they were trying to send a message to you? Sometimes when you're getting blown out, you want to punch back a little bit and say you're not going to lie down. Do you think the Bombers were trying to send a message?
Oh, I mean, most definitely. I mean, I felt the same way in a couple of the games that we played this year, and I wouldn't expect anything other than that with them being the professionals, them being in the situation they're in, us being in the position that we're in. You're going to get some of that heated turmoil there.
What's the mindset of this team this week now, finally, after getting that first win of the season after so many losses?
Definitely got the monkey off our back now. I just feel like we, relaxed now, just ready to go and ready to have fun. I think that's the main thing with practice this week. We're just having fun now and, understanding that we're not satisfied with this win, but we want to keep it rolling. So I think we're just excited to keep it going.
What are some of the challenges of facing the same team in a back-to-back situation?
Knowing what they did. That's all we did this week was watch the film on the game, just to understand a little bit more of what they're trying to do and what the advantages we have on them. So just watching film, understanding all the things that they try to do and just make it even better than what we did last week.
Can it be a challenge sometimes though? You look at what you see from them and you think, oh, they'll probably do the same, but then they're trying to do something different. Meanwhile, it's the same thing kind of in the other locker room, right?
It's kind of a mind game. It's kind of a mind game where we see something, they see something, they might switch it up, we might switch it up. So it's going to be a lot of fun just to get out there. It's supposed to be loud, so just excited to get out there and have fun.